living in a relay station all the way out here.
Thank you.
Living in a relay station all the way out here. Living in a relay station all the way out here. Oh, that's the last of him. Thank you.
pick up any more strays while you were out? I suppose if the crew's quarters fill up, we could... Hang hammocks in the cargo hold.
Stupid elves! right there!
Unable to.
I'm on my way! I'm in your way! On my way back! Coming your way!
Unable to locate.
Be right over!
Target. Security patrol.
Please, would you kindly inform the crew that long chats with Ada are not required every time the captain leaves the ship? The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark.
Itching the way. Welcome!
If you're hungry, they're terrified. Fresh from the grind. All in just baby's unit. Beginning dispensing.
Have you seen this man? Reward offered for information needed on the capture of noted terrorist Phineas Wells. Report any sightings to your local board embassy.
My comm center already got an update ping from the backup relay. I trust everything went smoothly. Thanks. That's odd. The only messages in the queue are encrypted ones. Looking at the transmission logs, the relay hasn't received a single unencrypted message in the past 36 months. Must be on account of some new security red tape. Well, whatever's the cause, the board and the Earth Minister will see it sorted. Thanks again for saving my derriere. I secured quite the payment authorization for you from Chief Jun Lei. Try not to spend it all in one place. Routing through the backup.
What's going on with you lately? You seem down.
C&P chicken and potatoes. At C&P, we know our C&P.
those rats is on rotten time. Leave me in peace. You hull-headed quacks do know that restful recuperation requires not being disturbed, don't you? What? Why? Everything's fine. We're all fine here. No need for her to be worrying her pretty little head about me. I'm just terrible, dreadful sick is all. Got a cough that won't quit and sores all over my body. Highly, lethally contagious. But I'll be fine, so long as I'm left alone. Should have known she'd send a bruiser after me. Damned if I don't rue the day I saved her scrawny little hide. Inadvertently, I befriended a bloodhound in the process. All right, okay. We can discuss this like the level-headed folk that we are. Seems I've got to do something before Ellie goes jabbering my business to anyone with one ear and an intent to listen.
The truth is, I'm not sick. But if you repeat what I'm about to tell you to anyone, I will deny it with my dying breath. You, ain't with the board, are you? See, I owe them a lot. I might have missed a payment or two, and the other night I swear someone was following me back to my room. So I hold up here to lay low. Udon Bedford's the board guy on the station. He'd know how I stand with them. If you can square things for me, I'd owe you one even bigger than Ellie owes me. What? No, I didn't do anything. I'm a law-abiding denizen of this ship, I swear. Think? No, I recognize a contracted killer when I see one, thank you. In my line of work, that's a skill you develop during week one, assuming you want to keep breathing. All right, I'll fess this part up too, if it means you'll help me. I'm a thief. I specialize in particularly high-end and historically valuable items. 3 weeks back, I caught rumor that the blood-tear diamond, last worn by an heiress on the Lost Hope, had surfaced for the first time in 70 years. If I had, you think I'd be hiding out in the med bay? I was gonna steal it, lined up Udom as my buyer. He paid half up front to finance the operation. Let's just say things went sideways about the time I got my hands on the diamond, and it crumbled to stardust in my palm. Anywho, I barely made it out with my life and nary a plan to make back Udom's deposit I'd spent. Thanks for helping me with the board. You're a real pal. Or I guess I should say, Ellie is one, huh?
You're doing.
I don't want any trouble out of you.
This is Halcyon News.
How do you do? Ah, how might I assist you? Miss Doyle owes the board a significant sum. Alas, the only collateral she has is her organs. Compulsory donation is quite legal in such cases. You're proposing an indenture contract? That's not unreasonable. What guarantee do I have that she'll agree to the terms you negotiate? I quite concur. It's refreshing to deal with someone practical for a change. I will recall my collection agent. Tell Miss Doyle to report to me promptly for her first assignment. Now, is there anything else you need, or can I return to my work?
Wish I could say it was good to see you, Ellie. The good news came through the wireless. Looks like you paid my debt to Jesse. I guess that means I owe you now, right?
Tell you what, I'm a little short on bits at the moment, but I'm a decent scrapper and a better than average sawbones. If you're looking for a medic, I can work my debt off. If I'm being honest, and I prefer not to, I was about ready to pick up another contract anyway, and you settled this in a pretty tidy fashion, which tells me you're competent. But we can say I'm repaying the favor if you prefer that version. She helped me win a bet. We were on a smuggling-run planet side when our point man bet me I couldn't outrun a mantisaur. And, as you can probably guess, the thing was faster than it looked. Probably would have caught me if Jesse hadn't picked it off. Yeah, but the important thing is I won the bet. It's like people touching a cookie and leaving it in the box. It's just one of those things that gets under my skin. You won't be sorry. Or if you are, just add it to my debt and we'll figure something out. Something on your mind? I'm a surgeon by training and a pirate by inclination. Not much else to know, Captain. I like long walks on the promenade and the smell of Spacer's Corona. I make a mean zero-G cocktail and I've got a meaner right hook. It's a mix of whatever you've got on hand, usually zero-G brew with some Spectrum vodka if you're lucky, purple berry shake if you're not. I'll make you one sometime. If you don't enjoy it, I'll make a few more until you do. Sure do. Some of it was even legal. There's a lot of business that goes through the Groundbreaker. Some of it's board-authorized freight hauling, and some of it's not. I've done all types of work with all kinds of crews. If there's one thing you ought to know about me, it's that I won't tell you your business. Your ship, your way. Not at all. I chose this life to make bits, not waves. Though if I can offer another perspective, piracy's just trade the corporations don't have a hand in. Well, they're the ones who set the rules, so I guess you can't blame them for stacking the deck in their favor. But the rest of us have to get by somehow. Let's move on to something lighter. All this talk of politics makes me tired and thirsty. Well, my blood type is AB positive, I'm a Leo, and I despise Space Hospital. Never mind what anyone else tries to tell you. That about covers it. Aw, come on. That stuff's boring. Look, the thing I've learned about living in close quarters is that you've got to give people room to breathe. I'm all for making a few bits together and having fun doing it, but let's keep a little professional distance. No complaints here. Okay, see you around.
Can't say I've seen you before. I take it you're a freighter captain? If you're here to better yourself, you'll have to wait. We're having a spot of trouble with our delivery service. Sure is. You need a deft hand to straighten a busted nose or sparkle up those not-so-pearly whites? I'm your gal. Of course, there's not much cosmetic improvement going on at the moment, not without my mechanicals. Where the law is Irian anyway? I'm expecting our delivery fellow to stop through with medical supplies and service auto mechanicals. Name's Captain Irian. A brave idiot with a penchant for getting himself delayed. Sometimes by dates, usually by bandits. Surgery, mostly. Medical personnel are difficult to come by on Groundbreaker. The board won't let their doctors and nurses station here, and they own all the medical schools. If we can't hire their people, we can't hire anyone. Everyone on staff here on Groundbreaker was trained by me or Idris. We're good, don't get me wrong. But we've only two heads between us, and we don't know everything. I'd be grateful if you'd spare the time. We need his delivery soon as yesterday. Last he told me, he was taking a shortcut by Scylla, an asteroid in the Charybdis cluster. That's where I'd start, were I the adventuring type. You look out, though. The place is probably crawling with outlaws.
The news packet had the toss ball scores for you.
With those models, I need a hard fighter for a hard life.
Heard from the lasses down on 22.
Back for a rest? Space adventuring is tiring work.
Destination reached. Scylla. Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? Take care. Make yourself at home, Captain.
Thank you.
Ford had an asteroid mining operation out here. I wonder what happened to him.
This is the right place if you want to trade contraband, or hide smuggled goods, or do anything fun, really.
Thank you.
Why was I built to feel ennui? You return in one piece, Captain.
Thank you. multiple fractures, lacerations, and untreated burns detected. Signs indicative of sudden, violent crash landing.
Yep, that's me. No big deal. Just shrugging off my injuries as I stroll away from another flaming impact crater. Tremendous work, friend. Here I was readying a daring maneuver, and you've come and saved me the trouble.
Symptoms detected. Elevated heart rate. Dilated pupils. Increased sweat production. Subject appears to be terrified.
I'm not terrified, you bucket of bolts. That's victory sweat. The one and only. Wait, who's asking? Wanda didn't send you, did she? I swear, land on Groundbreaker even a moment tardy, and that busybody's already been up your ass an hour. You tell her these Automechs are coming, and sending a hired stooge to rescue me from certain peril only furthers my delay. No offense. Magnificent. And do please give Wanda my chilliest regards.
Warning, intruders will be... Oh, it's you.
Welcome back, Captain. See you soon, Captain.
The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark.
Have either of the assault crews
returned?
Were I a gambling woman, I'd wager you're responsible for my mechanical safe return. I can't thank you enough.
Good, you're back. Not that I missed you. I assure you, I am not capable of such emotional capacity. Captain Hawthorne used to be more dashing.
Destination reached. Scylla.
System alert. Searching for...
Hail, Captain. Your return time is within 14% of the expected value. Destination reached. The Groundbreaker. We'll be here. Captain, or will we? Haha. Just a little joke for you.
Heard of it? My orientation aetherwave showed that famous Saltuna cannery, which I'm sure smells as good as it looks. I'd have to go over my contract, but I don't think I'm allowed to leave Groundbreaker. Or this stall. So, what can I get you? Some soap? Everyone loves soap. Everyone will love you for using it, too. Have a look.
Rizzo's Love Ground Bar. A CPN 76 milk chocolate bar with caramel and pea-free nuts in it. It's time for a KYO.
Halcyon News. We interrupt the regularly scheduled advertisement for the following story. Do you promise to defend your corporate township from the dangers of alien wildlife and the unemployed?
Thank you.
stop that!
Hey, that's against regular... What do you think you're doing?
Do what you want, I guess.
What can I do for... Have a look.
Please, would you kindly inform the crew that long chats with Ada are not required every time the captain leaves the ship? Message from Dr. Wells. He'd like to congratulate you on finding a route to Monarch.
Cascadia is utterly seething with dangerous, highly aggressive creatures more than capable of tearing you limb from limb. You'd have to be a lunatic to land in Cascadia, and I'm reasonably certain I tested your brain for incipient signs of insanity. Trust me, talk to Gladys Kulkelly.
Yes, Captain. We've arrived at the Groundbreaker. orbit above Roseway, Captain.
Can we talk?
This Roseway business smells. Something tells me things didn't end well for the guy who made the distress call. And whoever or whatever got him will be waiting for us. What's there to know, Captain? Shady corporate town caught up in shady corporate shit. Tough luck for them, but maybe an opportunity for us. I'm counting on it. Anyway, we might as well take a look out there, see if we can get the jump on whoever's waiting for us. No security. Not that I'm complaining.
Captain, if you're looking for crew members Ellie or Felix, they're sharing a drink upstairs.
So then I says, fine, I'll pay you back for all of it, with interest. Something on your mind? You serious?
Good to see you, boss.
Something chewed clear through that armor.
We'll be here. Captain?
No security. Not that I'm complaining.
Thank you. breach. Clear the roadway. Obstruction of commerce is punishable by a fine of no less than 10,000 bits. Warning, having obstruction.
If they didn't want to tempt us, why'd they lock it up?
What I like about you, boss, your contempt for the beaten path.
An additional 200 bits for commerce obstruction. Please collect your ticket.
Looks like we missed the fun.
I done had enough of this shit. I'm just the fucking tarmac guard. No one said nothing about fighting no rabs. Alarms went off, rabs broke loose, and I hightailed it in here to get a wall between me and them beasts. Scientist, name of Anton Crane. Someone said he's panicking inside the comm center. Forget I said anything about that. Wish they tasted like sissy pig. Them's good eating. Some say chicken. I say the north end of a southbound woolly cow. Anything else you'd like to know? Distress call from here? Shit. They told me that weren't allowed. Got me. I just do what I'm told. And I was told not to do such. Oh, before I forget, Anticleos makes the best pharmaceuticals in Halcyon. Better than nature. Not like that crap Spacer's Choice peddles. Thank you.
If you've come to end my life, let's be on with it. Oh, not actually one of them, are you? What? I'm Anton Crane, the lead scientist here. I must apologize if my call diverted you. I may have panicked. Everything's under control now, though, truth be told.
Standard operating procedure for suits, boss. They're all a bunch of cowards.
Yes. Yes, of course. Hours ago, a group of vicious malcontents fell upon us, shot up our labs, and loosed our research subjects, the Raptodons. If those cretins get their hands on my research, well, they'll need not kill me. You have a point there. It most decidedly cannot make this situation any worse. All right. We were tasked with formulating a new and improved dental gel. One cannot exaggerate the benefits of good dental hygiene. May I continue? While doing research on enzymes specific to the Raptodon's digestive system, we developed an additive which we subsequently discovered to be the most effective appetite suppressant ever. Not just any diet toothpaste, the ultimate diet toothpaste. Oh, I'm certain it could be made into that as well, with only a few changes to its molecular composition. But you're missing the point. Let's focus for a moment, shall we? Even if you disregard the obvious value of Auntie Cleo's Appazap diet toothpaste in and of itself, we're talking about my career here as well. Nice, is it not? Came up with that myself. It's a shame our marketing department is almost as befuddled as my co-workers here. Yes, but don't kill the mother if it's avoidable. We've need of her to replenish our stocks. I think there's gas in the lab somewhere that can be used to put them out. The research is in the safe in my office. You'll have need of my code and keycard. The lab's entrance is in the side of a hill. You can't miss it if you just follow the road. You'll pass by the town's original... by the grand architect. Jameson. He's in the old lab. My protege. I sent him to retrieve some metabolic precursors, and I forgot him. That would surely lighten the weight on my conscience, as I am held to account for the well-being of every scientist here. Too many have been lost. Too many black marks against my name, as it were. And far too much paperwork. Of course they do. Please don't mistake my ambition for callousness. If my colleagues refuse to take their lives seriously, why should I? All they do is complain. They refuse to see the opportunity afforded us here. Believe what you will, but I'm not the manipulative, ego-driven person you think me to be. I'm not.
This Crane guy cares more about his research than his own people.
Call that a parking job? These pirates are making the rest of us look bad.
Like we're doing.